I'll put you in front of my melody. You are all.
Thank God for His mercy, for His grace, for His protection. If not God, for all this we put together, we say God be praised in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring you greetings all the way from Athens, Greece. And for my wonderful husband, Pastor Smart, who signed for the General Overseer of God's Glorious Chapel International Gospel Ministry at Athens, Greece. Happy New Month. Welcome to the month of February, the month the Lord will fast forward your blessing, fast forward your victory, fast forward your prayers, requests, fast forward whatever you put in His hands. As long as you rely on Him and walk in His ways, you will see all your dreams coming to pass this month in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Last week, by the special grace of God, we talked about how can your plans succeed in this year, 2020. And the first point I gave was that you need to ask questions. Ask questions, seek for counseling, that all these things that you want in your life this year will come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. Ask from the reliable people, people that have the attitude, the right attitude, towards your plan, people that will make you succeed, people that will make you achieve your dream. Ask them that have been there, that have been successful. Let them mentor you, let them coach you, and you see yourself smiling this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Above all, ask the Lord whether this plan is from His will. If it's from His will and it's the will of God, why not? Go ahead and you see God making it possible in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Today, the second point is you need to have passion. Having passion is somebody that will not be lazy, will be determined to make sure that this plan comes to pass. You need to love whatever you want to achieve this year. You need to be happy in whatever you want to become this year. If you are not happy, if you are not having passion, if you are not having joy, you see yourself quitting on time. And you see yourself, why? I wanted this plan to come to pass. Why is it not coming to pass? Because you did not have passion. If you have passion, why not? It will surely come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. I am not saying having passion will not be discouraged. There will be discouragement. There will be at times the element created for us, created by God to help us, will be against us at times. But if you believe God, you see God turning those things around to be on our side, that we will be favored and we see our dream coming to pass this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ had passion to come and save us. Even when we are sinners, even when we do not love Him, even when we hated Him, He came with His love to come and save us. Was it easy for Him? No. Were they discouraged us? Yes. There are things that will make him to say he wants to give up. Yes, there was a time. He cried. But he asked God. He said, not his will, but the will of God be done. Why? Because he had passion that at the end of the day, this mission will bring success to him. So if you believe that your plan is in the will of God and is going to bring success to you, please, I urge you, please take it as a baby. Take it as your baby. Take it as something you know that without it, you cannot be somebody. So whatever you have put into God's hand this year, that is your dream, is your vision, or is a plan for you this year, please have passion for it. There is a man also in the Bible, Apostle Paul, that God called to come and preach His word. What did he do? He had passion. He was beaten. He was cursed. He was insulted. Even the people that he wanted to come and preach to, they despised him. But still, he told us in the word of God, in Philippians 3, 13 and 14, he said, I forget the past. If you don't forget the past of things that have dragged you back for this past decade, this new decade, even if you had dreams, it may not come to pass. But the passion inside of you, forgetting the past, being determined, no matter what people are saying, believing in yourself that yes, you can make this dream come to pass. Why not? It must be successful in the name of Jesus Christ. You need to look at that price. You need to look at the mark. You need to look at the profit. You need to look at the success concerning whatever you have committed into the hands of the Lord. Is it your marriage? Is it your career? Is it in the business? Is it in your ministry? Whatever it is it concerning your children? Please, if you have passion that this thing will come out to be good success and is going to bring blessing to your life, you will see it coming to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. According to the word of God, in also 2 Timothy, verse 4, 7 and 8, Apostle Paul said that I have fought a good fight of faith. You need to fight a good fight of faith. Anybody that have passion concerning his dream, concerning his vision, concerning whatever that he has been asking from the Lord, despite it's not coming to pass yet, if you have passion for it, I believe continue fighting. I believe continue fighting. I believe continue fighting. As long as you are fighting a good fight of faith, you will see a crown of victory be put on your head at the last day in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe you have understood what I'm trying to say, or you are getting what I'm trying to say. Please, I beg you in the name of Jesus Christ, you need to have passion. Don't give up. Don't give up, my brothers. Don't give up, my sister. Get up again. The Bible tells us if the righteous fall many times, seven times, you can still rise up again. Let God help you again. In that your marriage, concerning your children, concerning your career, concerning whatever it is, take the passion back again. I pray the Lord will strengthen your heart. I pray the Lord will help you again. I pray the Lord will help you to stand. Whatever you have lost, the Lord will bring it back again in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe this point will make you to sit up again, make you to encourage yourself in the Lord again, and run with that vision, pursue that vision, write it down, believe in yourself, believe that God is with you, believe that God will fight for you, and you see it coming to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. I know the Lord will help you this year. Anything you commit to the hands of the Lord, according to his word in Proverbs 16:3, he said it shall be successful. You shall be successful this year. Don't give up on yourself. Don't give up on your children. Don't give up on your marriage. Don't give up on your ministry. No matter what you are seeing at this point in time, the Lord will bring smile out of it in the name of Jesus Christ. Next week again, we'll be coming your way. I'll be coming your way to tell you more. Please don't miss any of this teaching. I'm bringing the third point, that what you need to know to make sure that your plans succeed this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Because you are there, you are down, you are frustrated, you are being depressed, I prophesy into your life that this new decade we have just entered, the Lord will strengthen you, the Lord will keep you, the affliction or the trouble you are seeing, the Lord will wipe it away and give you a new victory, a new state of mind in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like and share to your loved ones. Somebody needs this teaching. Somebody needs his job back again. Somebody needs this preaching. He needs his ear at peace back again. Give somebody a point to know that you love him by sharing this program to somebody this week in the name of Jesus Christ. Like our page, go to our website, go to our Instagram. Drop a point for us. Give us whatever you need to give to us by asking questions or commenting, and you see the Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. You need Jesus? Why don't you pray this prayer out? Pray this prayer out with me. Lord Jesus, I accept you into my life. I believe you are Lord. I believe you are my King. I believe you died and resurrected on my behalf. Father, I come back to you. Strengthen me back again. I've lost joy. I've lost passion of running the streets. Baba Lord, bring my passion back again. Bring my joy back again. Bring my strength back again. So, as you pray this prayer with me, the Lord will bring it all back to you again in the name of Jesus Christ. Look for a believing church to attend, and you see the Lord perfecting his work in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I love you, the love of Christ. Jesus loves you more. Next will be coming your way. Amen. Bless in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.